Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Hi there, in the next couple of videos, we're going to be building this formal business letter here in Microsoft Word 2016. All right, so let's get started. All right, so first things first, let's open up Word. I'm using Windows 10, and Microsoft 2016. To open it up, click on the little Windows icon. I find it's just easier where it says the bottom, it says Ask Me Anything. I'm gonna click Word, there he is there, open them up. Great, this is our initial screen. You can start with a blank document, which is what we're going to do in this video. But what you can do if you want to maybe save some time, and work from a template. Up the top here, there's search for templates. You can put in, say, letterhead, hit return. You need to be connected to the net because there are lots of stuff that it downloads from the net while it's working. So some sort of internet connection is helpful. You can see I put in letterhead and I've got a few options. There's not a huge amount. So when it comes to picking a template, often you got to kind of play with the words that you use. So instead of letterhead, if you just put in letter, you get a big difference in terms of the results. Can you see? This might be more what you're looking for, and this is what we're going to be kind of aiming towards for us. So have a look through this. This might be, you know, you might find something in here and you're like, job done, skip this whole series of videos and just start working from these letterheads here. I find these templates a little bit tough because there's lots of automated bits in them. So if you're new, you might find them not as helpful as they kind of appear to be. Now, even if you don't use these templates because there's kind of bits of automation in them, I find the language in them is really useful. If you need to, this one here, a letter confirming lost credit card, you need to have that pre-written, go in there, grab the text out of it and use it for your own stuff. There's some useful stuff and then there's some less than useful stuff. Like this one here, it's not less than useful. Employee termination letter due to poor performance. It's kind of scripted and written and there's some good ones and there's some interesting ones. But anyway, we're not gonna start with templates. So what we're going to do is we're gonna click the word home, and we're gonna start with a blank document. So the first thing we do with any document is give it a save. You can see up the top left-hand corner, there's this little old diskette thing, click save. And where we're gonna stick it, it's up to you where yours is gonna go. Probably the most common is if you click on browse, and if you go to your documents on the left, I'm gonna make a new folder in here to put all my files. Don't just dump them in here. You can, of course. But at the top here, it says new folder. If you're using an older version of Windows, sometimes you can right click and go to new folder. They're all slightly different. So with this new folder here, actually I'm gonna rename it. So I'm gonna right click it, go to rename, and this is going to be my Word class files. And we're gonna put everything today into that folder. When you've made a new folder and you hit save now, it's actually not gonna go inside of it until you click on it. Watch this, double click. And now I'm inside my documents, which is inside Word class files. And I'm gonna give this one a name. Now, when it comes to naming conventions, you can give it anything you like. So in my case, I'm gonna call it Bring Your Own Laptop. It's gonna be the company, and this one's going to be a credit letter that we're writing. And at the end of these things, often you can add a V1, V2, V3, for any adjustments you make, or comments that come back. Never call it final. Final is the kiss of death. If you call it final, you'll have final two, final revisited. Just a V1, V2 works great. Let's click save. All right, so that's the super easy stuff out of the way. Let's move on to the next video. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.